ओम स्वीट ओम इज अ पोएम रिटन बाय द पोएट जॉन ओवर्ड पेन. मिड प्लेजर्स एंड पैलेसेस दो वी मे रोम बी इट एवर सो हम्बल देर इज नो प्लेस लाइक ओम. अ चार्म फ्रॉम द स्काई सीम्स टू अलो अस देयर विच सीक थ्रू द वर्ल्ड इज नेवर मेट विद एल्सवेयर. ओम ओम स्वीट स्वीट ओम देर इज नो प्लेस लाइक ओम ओ देर इज नो प्लेस लाइक ओम. द मीनिंग्स ऑफ द वर्ड्स इन फर्स्ट स्टांजा आर मिड मीन्स अमिस्ट चार्म मीन्स मैजिकल पावर अलो मीन्स टू मेक इट ओली. द पोएट सेज दैट दो वी मे रोम अराउंड ब्यूटिफुल पैलेसेस एंड डिफरेंट काइंड्स ऑफ प्लेजर फील्ड प्लेसेस देर इज नो प्लेस लाइक ओम इवन इफ इट इज अम्बल. द पोएट फील्स दैट समथिंग मैजिकल पावर फ्रॉम द स्काई सीम्स टू ब्लेस हिज ओम मेकिंग इट ओली. Even if we find through the feelings of this world, we can never find it anywhere or elsewhere. The poet exclaims Om is sweet Om and says that there is no place like Om. An exhale from Om, splendor dazzles in vain. Oh, give me my lowly thatched cottage again. The birds singing gaily that come at my call. Give me them and the peace of mind dearer than all. Om, Om, sweet, sweet Om, there is no place like Om, oh, there is no place like Om. The meanings of the words in second stanza are, exile means to be away from your place. Splendor means magnificent. Thatched cottage means a cottage with a roof made from straw. Gaily means happily. In the second stanza, the poet says that, good and excellent things of beautiful places does not make depressed the poet to be away from home. The poet wants to stay a thatched cottage. It is a cottage with a roof made from straw. The poet wants that the birds should sing happily and respond to his call. Mostly, the poet wants the peace of mind that he has already at home than the dearer of all things. The poet exclaims, "Home is sweet home." And says that there is no place like Om. I gaze on the moon as I tread the drear wild and feel that my mother now thinks of her child. As she looks on that moon from her own cottage door through the woodbine whose fragrance shall cheer me no more. Om, Om, sweet, sweet Om, there is no place like Om, oh, there is no place like Om. The meanings of the words in third stanza are, gaze means to look at, tread means to walk lightly, drear means dull and uninteresting, woodbine means a climbing plant with a sweet smell yellow flowers, fragrance means sweet smell. In the third stanza, the poet says that when he looks at the moon in the sky, while he is walking through wild places, he feels that his mother is now thinking about him. As she looks at the same moon from their own cottage door. But when the poet is away from home, he remembers the woodbine, a plant whose sweet smell cannot cheer him anymore. The poet repeats and exclaims, "Home is sweet home," and says that there is no place like home. How sweet it is to sit neath a fond father's smile and the caress of a mother to soothe and beguile. Let others delight mid new pleasures to roam, but give me, ho, give me the pleasures of Om. Om, home, sweet, sweet Om, there is no place like Om, oh, there is no place like Om. The meanings of the words in fourth stanza are, neath means below, caress means a light loving touch, soothe means comfort, beguile means tempt. In the fourth stanza, the poet says that, how sweet it is to feel his father's loving smile and have a light loving touch of his mother to comfort and please you. The poet also says that let others roam around and enjoy in new places with great pleasure. But the poet wants to stay at his home. The poet exclaims home is sweet home and says that there is no place like home. To thee I will return overburdened with care. The heart's dearest solace will smile on me there. No more from that cottage, again will I roam, be it ever so humble, there is no place like home. Home, home, sweet, sweet home, there is no place like home, or there is no place like home. The meanings of the words in fifth stanza are: overburden means trouble, solace means comfort. In the fifth stanza, the poet finally says that he wants to return to his home full of worries, troubles and care. The poet feels comfortable to stay at home instead of roaming around in new places. He never wants again to move away from his cottage. The poet repeats and exclaims, "Home is sweet home," and says that there is no place like home. If you understood this English poem, give us the feedback or comments. Subscribe the channel, like and share. Thank you.